appreciate it. Praise the Lord.
Well,
it's good to be in the house of the Lord.
Amen.
This didn't happen because of me. It happened in spite of me. I've been praying all week, Lord. In fact, last week sometime I was talking to a minister and I said, you've been in services when you just walk in and it's different. You know it's different. It's just something there. Something's there. You know, God's always here, but there are some times that there's just that presence of the Lord. And I've been asking the Lord all week, Lord, I'd like to, just one more time, before I die, I want to be in service. Like that. And I believe I made it. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise God. Well, you wondered why I'm sitting down. I'm 85 years old, that's the reason I'm sitting down. You get 85, you sit down too. But I'm glad to be in Austin. I really am. I'm glad to be in the house of the Lord. Nothing like the house of the Lord. I prayed when I was a young man. I want to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, that I may behold the beauty, praise God, not the ugliness, not the bad things, and there's a lot of that goes on, but the beauty, praise God, the beauty of the Lord. And I see some beauty here, the beauty of the Lord, and I want to just thank you for allowing us to come, Brother Rose, Sister Rose, always so kind to us. Treats us better than we deserve, but God has been good to us. I've really been kind of suffering a little with my health. Yesterday, my face was hurting. I was thinking coming up here this morning, got to smiling a little bit. I remember when my son, about 5 years old, we visited the pastor and sat on the front seat with the pastor. And he walked up to him and said, "Does your face hurt?" He said, "Well, no." He said, "Well, it's killing me." So, my face was burned yesterday.
Sorry.
I hope I don't kill you this morning. Praise God. Well, God. You know, it's good to laugh once in a while. It's good. Just have a good time in the house of the Lord. I'm going to read from Hebrews. I don't know, probably the last two or three times I've been up here preached from Hebrews. I told my son yesterday, I thought the last time I was up there, used the same scripture, and he said, "Well, nobody will remember it anyway." So, you remember, I'm not going to go the same direction. I'm going to read. I want you to get my thought, if that's all you get out of this message today. If you get my thought, I really think it will be of help. Hebrews chapter 11. Verse 8. By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he had should afterward receive for an inheritance, obeyed and went out, not knowing whither he went. By faith he sojourned in a land of promise, as in a strange country, dwelling in tabernacles with Isaac, Jacob, the heirs with him of the promise of land. If you remember this, he sojourned, dwelling in tabernacles with Isaac and Jacob, heirs with him of the same promise. And then the next verse changes the thought completely. For he looked for a city which hath foundation, whose builder and maker is God. And then he talks about Sarah. 13th verse, these all died in faith, not having received the promise, but having seen them afar off, and were persuaded of them, embraced them, and confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims on earth. For they that say such things declare plainly that they seek a country. And truly, if they had been mindful of the country from which they came out, they might have had opportunity to have returned. But now they desire a better country, that is a heavenly. Wherefore God is not ashamed to be called their God, for he hath prepared for them a city. Praise God. My thought this morning is from a tent to a tabernacle to a city. Praise God. Praise God. From a tent to a tabernacle to a city. And I come up here today thinking I'm going to get somebody out of the tent. I wanted to see the tabernacle. Praise God. Praise God. You've been in a tent long enough. It's time to see the tabernacle. You know, I hadn't even thought of this, but I woke up early. You may be seated. I woke up early this morning, and this came to me. In my life, this part never came to me then, but I had already been studying this, but I spent 13 months of my life in a tent. And I pastored this church. This was the last church that I pastored. And I'm looking for a city. From a tent to the tabernacle. To a city. Praise God. Praise God. And I got to thinking, this might be the last message I'll ever preach. I don't know. And it really doesn't make a lot of difference. But if it is, I'm going to a city. Praise God. Get ready to sing it. In their song, this is "I'm Going to a City Someday." Yes. Praise God. You singers, can we sing? We're going. Where's Brother Dwayne? Praise God. He's working. All right. Praise God. Well, I know something about tent living. I've lived in a tent. You know, about all some of you folks know me. Down by the lake, weekend. Tent. That's your idea of tent. That's vacation time. No, I'm not talking about vacation time. It's not vacation time. This is home, friend. This is home. This is where we're gonna be for a while. We're gonna be here for a while. We're gonna be living in a tent. I remember the first place I was signed. We'd gotten off of a ship in Korea, and got on the train, an old train. Took us a long time to get up North Korea. We were traveling on the train. We got to wherever it was, and it was 7 below 0. 7 below 0 in a tent. I want to tell you something. And I didn't know. I really didn't know that this was not going to be. This is going to be it all the rest of the time we're over here. And we actually didn't have winter clothes. They told us that don't lay down, your feet might freeze. Tent. That's living in the tent. Praise God. I'm glad I'm in a tabernacle today. If you don't see anything beautiful about the church, just look around a little bit. Take a walk around the church. church. Every once in a while, we need to walk around the church. We need to see the beauty of the church. We need to see what's really in the house of God. Praise the name of God. We need to see it as a tabernacle, not just a place to come and maybe sit for 2 hours and not really touch the Lord. You know what? You know what makes the difference in the tent and the tabernacle? I did a little study. You know, I got this whole message out of. I'm not a Greek student, and I don't know anything about Hebrew, but I got this whole message out of this little narrow line in the middle of my Bible. You got a Bible that has a reference in the middle reference. Well, I got this thought, and this word jumped out. They were out in tabernacles, you know, and I thought, oh, when was this? When does Abraham and Isaac and Jacob dwelling in tabernacle? And I got to looking, and it says a tent. In the Old Testament, it said they pitched their tent. He put his tent on the mountain. Really, when we first start from the Lord, you pitch your tent on the mountain. You think it's all going to be like this. I want to tell you there's some sojourning you got to do before you get there. Yes, there is. There's going to be some time that you don't. You're going to wonder, am I going to make it or not? Will I really make it? But I'm going to tell you, you're going to make it by the grace of God. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. And you can stand the tent all of your life if you want to. But I want to see the tabernacle. I want to see the beauty of the house of the Lord. I want to see God. I want to know that I have God dwelling down in here. From a tent to a tabernacle. And Paul said, you are the temple of the Lord. Now, you know what makes a difference in a tent and a tabernacle, Brother Bats? The difference in a tent and a tabernacle is God dwells in it. And if God dwells in it, you may be seated. Praise God. Come on. Praise God. I'm getting stuff here. What really makes it, I run the reference on tabernacle. And all I could find of a tabernacle in the Old Testament was a tabernacle in the wilderness. Now, I have to admit, it was an elaborate tabernacle tent, but it was a tent. But what really made the difference, God was in it. And what really makes the difference, you know, it's not all just fun and games living for the Lord. There's some times of you're going to just have to sojourn. You just have to stay. Come on back and lift your hands if you don't feel like it. And just stay in there and make up your mind that by the grace and help of God, I'm going to make it. I'm going to make it all the way. I'm going to make it all the way home. I'm not going to live in this tent all of my life. Now, I didn't know when I was in crib whether I was going to stay there the rest of my life or not, because, you know, you get shot at over there. But I thank the Lord. The Lord let me live through it. And it wasn't all that at all. All the 10 living wasn't all 7 below zero. We had a floor in our tent. It's a kind of elaborate tent. It wasn't just the ground. They hauled in lumber, and we had a floor in our tent. Even had a front door in the tent. But it's still dark. When that old motor go out at 10 o'clock at night, you hear the lights going out. Praise God. The generator is quitting. And brother, you better have a candle lit, because it's going to get dark in here. Yeah. And there are sometimes you better just light a candle. But keep a little light in your life. Praise God. Just come on back to the house of the Lord. Yeah. You know, in fact, I should have read it. Abraham put his tent in the mountain first. But he went right on down to, the Bible said he went south, and there was a famine. There's going to be a time there's a famine in the church. Praise God. You know what you got to do? You got to go back to the prayer room and pray it down again. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. There's going to be times that it's not going to be so beautiful all the time. But I thank God for the tent we had to live in. It wasn't just a pup tent. It was a 15-man tent. And we had 6 or 8 guys in there. And it just got a little better. Got a better living But it is never like living in the tabernacle. It's never like when God really touches your life. And every once in a while, we need to ask the Lord, Lord, would you help me? There's no windows in the tent. Do you know that? It's dark. It's cold. And it's hard to live in. But if you just make up your mind, by the help and grace of God, I'm going to make it. I had a wife at that time and a little boy. In fact, he came along while I was over there to come back home to, and I'm going to make it. So you got to get your mind made up that I'm going to make it by the grace of heaven. Sometimes it's not so much the physical surroundings that makes a difference, it's your attitude toward it. Amen. Just your attitude toward it. Not so much the tent. It got to be pretty livable place. But the attitude that we have sometimes. You can either make the church just a tent, or it can be a tabernacle. You can make it just a boring experience, or you can make it a tabernacle. You know, just go out to the tabernacle and let's worship the Lord. Let's ask God to send him up. In fact, I honestly prayed all week long, Lord, I just like that. One more time, I want to just walk in the church and just feel that sparkle. You know? Yes. The sparkle of the presence of God. Now, I've preached when it's like waiting molasses. Amen. And if you're going to sit down, I'll just wave the molasses. We're going to preach here this morning by the grace and help of God. But I want you to get what I really saw, because if you can get a hold of it, it'll change. It'll make you look around at these old brothers and sisters that you're so accustomed to. They look beautiful. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. It's a beautiful thing. Just old age works on you. Yesterday, I got up and I told my wife, I said, man, I can't get warm. I'm cold. I keep putting on clothes and putting on these. And I said, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to go get in the shower and I'm going to get warm. And I did it. Got in there and got all warmed up. You know what? Come out, the temperature in the house hadn't changed a little bit. Nothing changed, but something changed on the inside. I felt better. I was warm on the inside. And I got to pray, Lord, that's what I want. I want you to do tomorrow. I want the Holy Ghost just to fall. I tried to dance, but I'm fixing to dance. How long Abraham spent in Canaan? Abraham spent 100 years in Canaan. He was 75 years old when he went to Haran. And the Bible said when he died, he was 175 years old. He lost his wife. And it gone through life. He had to lot off down in Sodom and got lost, got stuck, and got caught. In fact, the war got him, took him away. You know, he didn't just say, well, you know, that's good enough for him. You know what he did? He said, let's get some trained servants. Let's get some of my servants. Let's go get him. Praise God. Let's bring him back. Let's go after him. You know, every once in a while we need to ask the Lord if my brother or my sister needs help. Let's go after him. What do you say? Let's fight that old devil that would like to take you down. Let's fight that old devil that would like to destroy you. Let's get a hold of times. Lord, we're gonna pray until something happens. We're gonna get in touch with God because it's a wonderful thing to be in the church, in the tabernacle. Praise God. I've been studying, asking God, Lord, would you just look down? I want that touch this morning. Just something like that, a touch of God. But there's a lot of living to do. There's a lot of time that pressure, you know. We find Abraham, after he went south, he got into trouble and famine, went into Egypt, came back out. You know what it said? You know what the Bible said? He went back to the same place that he started from, back where the altar was. Every once in a while, we need to go back to the altar. I'm going back to the altar. It's time for me to get back and just touch the Lord. Nothing so complicated about serving the Lord is just keep the Spirit of the Lord in your life. And keep the Holy Ghost moving in your life. That's what it really takes. Just make up your mind that, Lord, whatever it takes, I've got to have you. I don't think God, in fact, I know it. And you read, Abraham made the mistake of Ishmael. And a part of the way it looks, 13 years before God spoke to him again. 13 years. Before Isaac came along, God met with him. Sometimes there's times you just gotta soldier. Just stay in there. Just live. We're not living for the Lord, for what's in it here particularly. Praise God. But I'm looking for a city. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I'm looking for something better than this. And one of these days, we're going to go there. But first, there's some soul journey to do. We've got to stay close to the Lord. Yeah. Problems in the church, you know, every once in a while, church has a problem.
Sure.
If you didn't know that, why? Still not one. Praise God. You know, Abraham's and Lot's herdsmen got to fussing with one another. Your cattle's eating my cattle's grass, and he had to separate from Lot. He said, "I'll tell you what I'll do. You go one way, I'll go another. Just we can get along. You know, when we have problems, there's a way out. Yes, sir. There's a way out. In the church, there's always a way out. Because God wants you to make it just as you want to make it. And I got to make it. Whatever it takes, I got to make it. The Bible said he sojourned with Abraham, with Isaac, and Jacob. Abraham. I just picked this up this morning. If it means anything or not in this message, if I kill it, we'll get back here somewhere. But anyway, this was in my office, and I picked this up, and here's the crowd that I soldiered with when I was an officer. Here they are. Praise God. There's great people. Love the Lord. And every once in a while, you need to just look around the church. There they are. Sister Joe, your picture's in here. Just Mary. Praise Brother Rath. Brother Rath and Brother Rhodes. These hard-headed men. Praise God. That's good. Praise God. I thought I'd have to pull them apart every once in a while and warp them. Praise God. You thought everything's just sweet and everything's going on just well. You know, sometimes you have to put up some hard-headed people. They love the Lord, too. And they're going to a city. Amen. Amen. You hear me? Everybody don't have to be perfect to go to heaven. Thank you, Jesus. Just live for the Lord. Yes, every once in a while we need to just ask the Lord, just help me to get over it. In fact, I told you, Brother Rose, he told me the first board meeting, and we went to the back here and met me. He said, Brother Fennel, I never voted for you. But he said, here I am. Anything you want, I'll do it. He proved it. Ever, anything I want. He put a dog pen out here for my dog. It was just a revolt. Praise God. It's so wonderful to have people that love the Lord. Just, we've got to make it. By the grace and help of the Lord. Just, whatever it takes, we've got to make it all the way home. And I'm here today to get you out of the tent. Come on. Let's get out of the tent. You know, it's 9 o'clock every night. The lights would go out when I was in the tent, and it's terribly dark in there unless you light a candle. You know, you know what's going to happen. You know that it's going to get dark. So what you do, you light a candle before that happens. But just in case you don't, it's going to be mighty dark. But I want to tell you something. The church is beautiful.
Yes.
Praise God.
Yes.
And I'm looking for a seat.
Yes. Yes.
You know, I took this in a reference, and that's about all I can handle anymore. At 85, they ain't no use of me studying Greek because I couldn't remember that. See, I'll never be able to tell you what I studied. If I had. Nevertheless, get all of it. But I looked in that center reference, and I said, I wonder what's next here, you know. He kind of turns the thought there, and he said, and he looked for a city. But you know what? I checked that city, and I should have read all these scriptures this morning, but I think you get the gist of it. I looked for that city, and you know what he gave me? You know, Revelations 20:21, and I turned over there, and I saw the city. Praise God. There's the city that Abraham was looking for. Foundations. Beautiful. Praise God. Gold and all kinds of beauty in that temple. Thank you, Jesus. That's what we're looking for this morning. I'm looking for a city. I don't know about you. You can stay in the tent if you want to. You can stay in the tent. I want to look at the tabernacle. I want to go to the house of the Lord. These days, one of these days, we're going to leave this old world.
Yes.
One of these days, we're going to leave it all behind, because the Lord is coming after a people just like you. You know what makes the difference in a tent, in a tabernacle? Just a little bit of faith. Frame the tent over into the chapter of faith. And the writer said they live in tabernacles.
Right.
Praise God. Praise God. If you'd asked Sarah about that tabernacle, you know, I didn't read part about Sarah. Got down to Sarah, it said, by faith, by faith, by faith. And it came to Sarah. It said, through faith. So I wonder what caused it to change. It changed the gender. I wonder what happened. I looked up that word through, and the word through means to pass through without obstruction. Just, I'm with you. I'm with you. Said Abraham, no doubt, told Sarah, we're going to move. So where are you going to? I don't know. How did that work out?
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't know. So where are we going to live? Said, we're going to live in a tent. From the land of Ur of Chaldea, Abraham's father, I understand, was a God maker. He was an idol maker. And we're going to leave all this, whatever it is, and then go someplace you don't know where we're going. Every once in a while, we have to just trust God.
Yeah. Right.
Lord, your will be done, whatever. Whatever. Just say, Lord, just work your will in my life. Just whatever it takes to work it out, just work it out. I believe this morning there's no doubt somebody here, you need to just come out of that tent and see the tabernacle. Just see the beauty of the Lord. Just see the what God has done. You know, God looks at things different than we look at. We're in Spring Hill. Every once in a while, I look out my window, and there go a family, two little girls, and the mom and dad pulling them in a red wagon going down the street. And I've been to the house, and I'm not going to go into all of that, because what I want to tell you is that I look out there in Minden, and there's two young ladies. And if there's anything moving at all, they're out there getting with it. Praise God. Praise God. Beauty of the church. That's what God can do. That's what God can do. Fred, I want to tell you, you can't make it without the Lord. You got a family? You need God. They need to know that there's a God that answers prayer. They need to know. You need to leave them a little bit of faith. Not leave them anything materially, but if I can just leave my children faith, if I can just put within them, there is a God, there's a place you can go to, there's a place you can turn to, there's something in that God, it is a place you need to turn to.
Yes.
Praise God. Leave faith in the heart.
Amen.
Praise God.
Yes, yes.
I know where to turn.
Yes, sir.
I know where to go.
Yes.
Wouldn't the lights go out? I know what to do. Just take him to the house of the Lord and let him get acquainted with him. Almighty God.
Amen.
I told this, I guess I heard Brother Oggs tell this when he was living. He said he had took a blind boy to a camp down in Tioga, and he took him to the choir. He took him, showed him all the place around, and showed him the concession stand, took him to the concession stand, this concession stand. And a young man finally said, Brother Oggs, take me to the altar, and I can find everything else from there. Praise God. Just take me to the altar, and I can find my way. And friend, if you want to find your way, just go to the altar. Go back to God. Go back to that first place. Go back to that mountain that you built an altar on. And this is exactly what Abraham did when he needed to touch the Lord. After he'd been through a few battles and had a few scars, he said, I'm going back. He left Egypt. The Bible said he went back to the same altar. He went back to the same place where he started. Praise God. I don't know how long it's been since you've really just gone to the altar and said, Lord, I want you to touch my life. I want you to do something in my life. I want you to move in my family, in my home. Praise God. Praise God. I don't just sojourn. I don't just live. I think the Lord's let me live to be as old as I am. But many times when I go to the church, even when I go to bed at night, I give my children a prayer for them. God, would you touch my children?
Yeah.
Yes.
Would you just touch them just some way? Would you give them an opportunity? Just give them mercy. Someone said, well, there's no use there. Oh, friend, I want to tell you something. There is some need to. You keep on asking God. You keep on asking God. You're looking at, I started saying young man. You're looking at an old man that mother prayed for me. Praise God. Yes, she did. I remember my mother every night, she didn't miss, every morning. She got down on her knees in the chair in the living room. You could get down if you would. But she was going to pray, and she prayed, God, save my children. And she named them. She named every one of them. She called her grandchildren and the great ones. The little church in Tyndall, Arkansas, still most of that church is her family. Now, I hung around the church. I never really went a long ways out there. But I remember my brother. He didn't like to go to church from the get-go. I remember screaming, not wanting to go to church. We went to church. And then got a little older, my dad and all the fox hunters, they sit outside on a Model T, Fenders A, Fenders, and talked about hunting and whatever else. Fox hunters, there's fox hunters in that area. Well, church was going, I said, if I pastored that church, I think I'd have to go out and yell at them out the toilet. Do you think anybody's going to live for the Lord? You out here talking about hunting and fishing and the ladies in there worshiping the Lord. You know what? My brother, he would leave there, go downtown, and do whatever they did. I remember coming home with the smell of my smoke. And then I remember smelling like booze, but I heard my mother get down. God, save him. Verbal. Would you save him? I saw him come in the back door of that old church one night, wide as a ghost. He never did tell me. I don't know this day. He's gone now. I don't know what happened. How come him to come back from downtown, come in the church, went to the altar, hadn't heard a message? Nothing happened. But from that day on, Earl was a changed man. Praise God. That's what happens in the tabernacle. That's what happens in the church. That's what happens when you stay in there. Just keep on sojourning. Just make up your mind. Whatever it takes, I'm going to make it by the grace and help of God. Praise God. I see something out there. And it's worth every hard trial. It's worth everything you've ever gone through just to make it through. Praise God. I don't know. I'm about to quit here. I think it'd be good for us to stand. And I don't know if we could sing that song. I'm going to a city. But why don't we just come around the altar here this morning? Is this the way we dismiss Brother Brewster? Praise God. Why don't we just come around the altar here? Some of you may have some children. You may have come to give up on some prayers. I want you to pray them again. I want you to build that altar again in your mind and in your heart and make up your mind. By the grace and help of God, my children's going to hear me pray. They're going to see the beauty. They're going to see the beauty in the house of the Lord. I'm going to talk about it to them. You know what God told Israel to do in Deuteronomy? He said, you talk to them when you're going down the street. You talk to them when they get up in the morning. You talk to them all through the day. You talk to them about God. Talk to them about the beauty of the house of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Let's